one thing. If you contact the dead for personal gain, there will be tragic consequences.
Just dial my dead brother and shut up.
You should heed your brother's word.
We don't need you anymore, lady. Take off!
You shall not be warned again. The stupid one. He opened the box, yes? You had to open the box, mucho loco, capata. Yes? Any small change to help a poor soul?
Oh, of course. Just a moment. Oh, here's a little something, dear. And you must be hungry. I just baked it this morning. Oh, and that would go lovely with a cup of tea.
How about you, dog? Thank you for your kindness. What about the bald one?
Yes, Eustace, you must have something to give.
Yeah, I got something to give.
Upon your shiny head, a curse.
Huh?
Long as your soul lives in your purse, and with your coins you cannot part, your sky shall be dark as your heart.
Gobbledygook. Ain't no such thing as curses. And there ain't no such thing as parties.
The stupid one. He's stupid, right?
Mm-hmm.
There is nothing I can do. The farmer has to remove the curse by finding generosity in his heart. And he can only do that by seeing himself the way he really is.
Mm.
But I feel sorry for you. For a few pieces of silver, I could sell you this mirror. All you have to do is hold it up to the stupid one. I hate spring cleaning. Junk! Junk! Big junk! Junk! Get your junk! Fresh junk for sale! Get your junk! Could it be? No. Could he possibly have? No. That wouldn't happen to be a Velvet Vic record, would it?
Help!
To get Velvet Vic in and the wife of the stupid one out, you have to play the record while he's performing the song. I'm afraid no magic can fix this. Go digital. I'll take that. And this.
Hey, that's mine.
licensing fee.
Why are you making them weird sounds for?
She sighs because she burns to possess the beautiful amulet.
Mm-hmm.
You may have the precious treasure for a mere $5.
$5 for that? You're crazy!
$5.
Okay. I'll give you the dog.
Stupid dog!
Fine. Take this. The deed to my oil well.
An oil well? Yes, that is a price worthy of so fine a gift. This is not oil well. This is oil bill. I have been swindled. Swindling man and swindling wife, bear this curse upon your life. Instead of swindling for your lover, you shall swindle one another. Those two swindlers get what they deserve. Let's see how those teenagers who don't share food are doing. They give me rotten bananas, so I give them rotten bananas. Swindling begets only swindling, just as selfishness begets banana heads. Giving back what your friends have swindled will not undo the curse. They must suffer.
It is too bad.
But what is this? That is so sweet. He brings her comfort. He cares about the suffering of another. I undo the curse. The stupid one has taken on the pain of his wife. He has learned to give relief and share pain. I take away curse. Your Muriel will not speak because of this stupid one. What is it I can do? Okay, I will unleash forces which can only be stopped by the sound of your Muriel's voice.
Huh?
These are powerful forces. Very powerful. I will make a spell. From deep below the planet's shell. Deeper than the deepest well. May forces rise to break the ground. And cause your Muriel to sound. There's more. If your Muriel won't speak, much havoc will these forces wreak. Or in other words, it will not be pretty. So it begins. If I were you, I would get to your Muriel before it does. I can provide speedy transportation. For a fee. Don't you have anything bigger? It will have to do. We'll be right back.